Hello and welcome back to iBluairJgR Gaming for Comedy. This is UNCUT XCOM 2 Alien Hunters featuring Shen's Last Gift.
Commander, that UFO contact has us locked in. We have to take evasive maneuvers.
Damage report.
We've got a problem.
Only one?
They've just dropped some sort of spike outside. It's generating the same type of pulse that knocked us out of the sky.
They don't want us. They want the ship.
Isn't there some way you can override it?
Not from here. I can't get our engines online while it's out there.
Commander, we're gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way. Destroying that spike is our only chance of getting out of here. We can't let the aliens take this ship.
Okay, it's time to get serious, folks. We've got to defend the Avenger. Ain't no time for joking around. Let's go over the squad. We're going to start from the front. Rob Coolblue and Kandel Jack, both specialists. Kandel Jack is sort of a hybrid offense and healer, and Rob Coolblue is just straight up combat hacker. Next up, Oliver Jones. He's coming out of retirement for this one. He is not happy at all. But I think he's a little bit happy that he's getting the dust off the bolt caster. He's getting to polish it up, taking out that enhanced Shadowkeeper pistol, the tracer rounds, and the frost bomb. Even though we've eliminated all of the alien rulers, I have a feeling that we might still get some cool uses out of the frost bomb, especially on this mission. So next up, Tracy Donalds, our second sharpshooter. She's coming in with the Halo Reach DMR, the battle scanner, and a med kit. We're going to need a lot of those, so we may as well bring an extra one on her, because she's going to be right back at the base for the majority of the mission, doing what she does best, sniping people. Next up, we have Melissa Hayes. She is our grenade focused grenadier. She's using that exosuit, so she has a rocket launcher and she has three grenades because of one of her abilities. And last but certainly not least is Chang Little Ho. He's coming in as our gun focused grenadier with his stasis vest. I remember the name. I've never used this item before. It's really cool. The armor penetrating rounds and an acid bomb. So if there is armor to melt, he's going to be the one to melt it. So let's get into this. Oh man, Oliver Jones does not look happy. He's doing that slow walk. He's like, yeah, y'all done got me out of bed for this shit. Y'all about to get it. Y'all about to get it real good. So this is going to be the Avenger defense mission. Our objective is to get to that spike like object and destroy it. All right, so we need to destroy that because it is putting out some sort of dampening field and it's disabling our engines, and that's not a good thing. So once we destroy that thing, we get everybody back to the Avenger, then we can fly away and be all happy. So that is what we're gonna try and do. So the Avenger defense mission is a very difficult mission. No matter what point in the campaign that you actually run into it, it's always gonna be incredibly difficult. The only difference is if you run into it earlier on, you have to deal with less abilities from enemies. When you run into it at a later stage, you have to worry about more enemies having different and unique abilities. Like the Sectopod, he's got a lot of abilities. The Archon has a lot of abilities. And that makes it a little bit more difficult. But generally speaking, it's just, this mission's going to break your balls no matter what. There's no other way to put it. This mission will break your balls. Plain and simple. So it's not gonna be fun. I'm not gonna like it. I'm gonna be blood pressure through the roof by the end of this. But you know, we're gonna try our best. We're gonna try our best to get out of here and make the best of this situation. We're not going to overextend. Extending too far is definitely going to be, will be the death of us if we play this wrong. And as you can see, we do have access to some turrets, and that is because, look at this. They're all clumped together like assholes. Okay, so, but yeah, I did complete the defense matrix, so I do have access to these turrets. They each have two action points, and one action point is used to fire. So they can shoot twice in a single turn, or they can fire and then go on Overwatch. It all depends on how you're feeling at any point in time. So let's get everybody into position and get ready to wreak some serious havoc. Oh, this is beautiful. No pun intended. Am I right? Argus the Cyclops, a.k.a. Havoc, about to move into position. Get that Rainmaker ready. Rainmaker is one of his passive abilities. It increases the radius of his rocket launcher. Ooh, this is exciting. Ooh, this is exciting. I wasn't expecting this. I really wasn't expecting them to be clumped together like assholes. But I'm not complaining about it. I'm really not complaining about it. We've got to make room for people. We got to move people around. We got to shuffle into good positions for this. Ooh, I'm so excited. I'm so hype right now. You know, I was feeling a little tired. I was feeling a little out of the weather, under the weather, whatever the hell it is. But not anymore. Oh, I'm ready. Oh, I'm ready for this to kick off. Oh, this is going to be so good. Okay, let me stop. I'm repeating myself too much. So what we're going to try and do, I may as well just come right out the gate with the rocket, with the Rainmaker. If we can, don't fuck with me now. All right, we're going to have to use overdrive to get into a better position because there's a lot of debris in the way that's actually blocking our angle from getting that rocket in properly. Now, this is a dangerous maneuver. Argus could still actually take a lot of damage from doing this. But I think it's going to be worthwhile in the long run. We're going to give him aid protocols and everything. We're going to make sure Argus doesn't take excessive damage. So, Chlori, if you're still watching, there's no need to fear. I'm still going to protect your boy. I'm going to keep your boy safe out here. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Play of the game. Right there. It's not going to kill anybody, but my goodness, that's a lot of damage. Holy shit. All right. So that's step number one. Step number two is going to be to fire another rocket and to just hopefully eliminate as many targets as possible. Look at this. Play of the game. That may be the only thing I like about Overwatch. Fucking brilliant. You can't tell me that's not badass. What the hell? What the hell? All right, I almost forgot to give him aid protocol. All right, we're gonna give him, where are you, Argus? Come on. There you are. We're going to give him the standard aid protocol for now. I'm not going to use... I do have Candle Jack with me, and he does have access to the... what is it called? Threat assessment version of the aid protocol, which is essentially an enhanced version of aid protocol. But we don't really need to use that right this minute. Not specifically on Argus. Argus doesn't need it. All right, so we're going to just move up. Get it? We still got a couple of action points left. We got a couple more moves that we can make, and I feel like we do have the luxury right now to be a little bit aggressive. What happened to my cover? What? Alright, so apparently, just the sheer force of the rocket that I launched shook that tree that Li Mei Ho was hiding behind, and now she's no longer in cover. But thankfully, she is concealed, so it's probably. It's not that bad. And I actually just made a bad move. I should have taken the shot with Chang Ho initially before taking the shot with Candle Jack because Chang Ho is using, he has holo targeting on his weapon. And what that is going to do is it is going to increase everyone else's chance to hit. I'm playing a little sloppy today. So you're going to have to forgive me for that one. But at the end of the day, might work out. Nope. Nope, that didn't work out too good. Not too well. All right. All things considered, I ain't mad at it. I am not mad at what just happened, and you shouldn't be mad either. You know, if you play XCOM yourself, I know you're probably thinking, oh, this is some nonsense. I ain't never got lucky like this on the Avenger Defense mission. It's usually 18 Sectopods, 15 Chrysalid, all right on the start of the gate before the mission even begins. But I got lucky. What can I say? I'm not upset about it. And so a cool thing about the Avenger Defense missions is that you do get reinforcements, but for some reason, mine are bugged. Whenever I get reinforcements on this mission, I'm not sure if it's because of one of my mods or what have you, but they are bugged and they can't move, they can't do anything. Their actions are not working properly. So what we're going to do is we're going to take all the people that spawn in and we're going to put them in the penalty box in this corner. TTC, that is teleport to cursor, and then we're just going to play this like a normal sort of mission. So, another side note about the Avenger Defense missions is that we can send wounded soldiers onto the battlefield. You can actually field the Spark unit when he's wounded all the time. That's just a fun fact, but I never do. I'm not going to tell you why. It's because I cheat. But what we're going to do, we're going to repair him. So this is the cool new ability that he unlocked. And essentially, Argus, our Spark unit, is essentially the perfect tank now because he can take damage, and now he can heal himself up after he takes that damage. And I'm not sure if I can actually make him heal more damage as I upgrade him, but we'll find out soon enough, won't we? So this is pretty cool. We're actually off to a really good start, and we can actually kind of bunker a little bit and wait for the enemies to start advancing on us a little bit, but we are going to move just... We're going to play sort of a hybrid game right now. We're going to advance with a couple of guys, and they're going to be sort of the elite task force. If you watch the Blacklist, that is why that thought was at the top of my head. I like the Blacklist. It's a cool show. It's on Netflix. I lost my train of thought. I don't know what the fuck I'm trying to say right now. Overwatch, that's what I'm trying to say. But what we're going to do is we're going to have sort of an elite task force going on, and what they're going to do is they're going to try and get to the spike while the rest of the guys are going to stay a little bit further back and just play the range game, play that sort of bunker down strategy. And I think it'll work out pretty well. I feel comfortable about doing it that way. The Avenger Defense, it just has so much potential to go wrong. So that's the only reason I'm a little bit hesitant about my current strategy. But I believe in myself. So Lee Mayho, we're not ready to engage with her just yet, so we're going to hunker down and just wait and see what happens. And we don't actually have a time limit for Avenger Defense missions, but we do have sort of a soft... Oh my gosh, everybody's missing. Thank you. Somebody remembered their training. Come on. That's what I'm talking about, getting that big damage. That's what I'm talking about. But there's sort of, if you play MMOs, then this term will be familiar, or RPGs, but there's a soft enrage timer for this, and essentially what that means is the defense is going to get progressively more and more difficult. And it's not just because this thing is slowly marching its way towards the Avenger. It is because... My goodness, this is cinematic as hell. But it is going to get more and more difficult because the reinforcements are infinite. And these guys are just hunkering down next to the spike. So that's going to be difficult to deal with when the time comes. Damn. Well, you done made a mistake, boy. You're going to get chopped up for that. Oh, he was just running. He wasn't even trying to attack anybody, so that's interesting. But yeah, so it's going to get progressively more and more difficult. The longer we take to eliminate the initial enemies that are on the field, the more difficult things are going to be because they're going to keep calling reinforcements. They're just going to keep coming and coming and coming. It's going to be crazy. It's going to be insane. And I don't like it. You know, it's like that annoying... The Avenger Defense missions are very... They're just annoying. Because I mean, they're really cool, but they're annoying because they're difficult, and that's the only reason they're annoying. You know, if I could, I would skip it, but I'm not gonna skip it. So let's hack into this guy and see what we get. Oh, look at that. I have a 100% chance to shut down this mech, and that is exactly what I'm going to do. I just don't want to have to deal with it. The mechs are annoying. Boom, shut it down. I could have attempted to control it. It's too risky. Too risky. 56% in XCOM may as well be zero. But there was actually something I wanted to bring up when I eliminated that first pod, and it's the concept of deleting things, right? The concept of deleting, whether it's, whether you're deleting somebody off your friends list or you're blocking somebody or what have you. But deleting things, the internet, it does a lot of bad things, right? It messes a lot of things up. But one thing that I will give the internet credit for is the fact that this is a bad move. I'm playing really stupid right now. What the hell is wrong with me? The one thing that I will give the internet and digital mediums credit for is the delete function. And the delete function is quite literally the most amazing thing in the world. And we're going to touch more on that in a second, but what we're going to do is we're going to activate the ability Chain Shot. So what this is going to do with Chang Ho is he's going to take two shots back to back if the first shot connects. So if the first shot connects, it has an aim penalty, then he's going to take a second shot automatically. It does have... It's a risky maneuver. But if it lands... Oh, baby, if it works. Yeah! That's what I'm talking about. Shred that armor. Shred it. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, so we did some nice damage. We used a lot of our ammunition, but that was beautiful. That's the perfect example of that was a perfect textbook. Textbook. Am I tired or something? What the heck? Like, what the hell is going on? So let's reload. We do have a shot that we can take with this turret, so we're going to take that. And we're trying to delete this sectopod, and I'm going to finish it off with somebody that could still use a promotion, just because why not? It's kind of nice to be able to control who gets the kill, because the turrets, we can't level up the turrets, so why bother trying to let the turret get the kill? But we can level up Argus, but he can't actually get the kill on it. What I'm doing right now, I shouldn't be doing it. I shouldn't be concerning myself with giving this kill to a specific person. But damn it, I want to. Damn. Okay, so now we can sort of guarantee that Argus gets the kill. I'm playing really poorly today. For anybody that's a really hardcore strategist in XCOM, I do realize that I could have given somebody the aid protocol with Candle Jack, which would have given them threat assessment. I fucked up. I acknowledge that. But it's okay. We're doing all right. We're doing all right. All right. That's all I can say about that. We're doing all right. Even though we're making mistakes, we're playing very poorly. We're doing all right. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we're doing okay. We're doing okay. I'm not getting punished too hard for making bad decisions. So I'm happy. But the concept of deleting things is very satisfying, especially deleting people. Now, think back to a time you were in a relationship with someone and they were getting on your nerves. They were bothering you, and you were just tired of it. And you didn't want to deal with them anymore. And you had a choice to make. Do I keep this person in my life? Do I just say, you know what, I don't want to deal with you anymore, and then just hope that they respect that? Or do I freaking hit the delete button on their ass? That's the question that you always have whenever you're trying to get rid of somebody from your personal life or from your private life or what have you. You have to ask yourself the question, do I just want to hopefully, just let them disappear on their own? Or do I want to get rid of their ass the right way? And the right way is the delete way. And it feels good when you delete somebody. Just think back to that time. Ooh, Nice one. You're having that argument. It's like, you know, I'm tired of this. I don't feel like dealing with you no more. What part of that don't you get? And then you just have this click in your mind. It's like, you know what? I ain't gonna deal with this no more. I'm deleting your ass. And you delete them, and then they're just gone. They're just gone forever. And sure, they could make a new, they could get a new phone number and contact you again. They could make a new email account and contact you again. They could do a lot. There are a lot of ways for people to pester you, to get on your nerves, to get under your skin, and continue to get under your skin even after you delete them from your phone book. But that takes a lot of work. And honestly, if you're willing to buy a new phone just for me so that you can bother me, I mean, fine. Let's talk it out. Let's figure out what the problem is. And apparently the Intimidate failed, but he still panicked. So apparently it didn't fail. Go figure. Nice shot, buddy. I approve of what's happening here. Yeah, I respect it. But yeah, it's, you know, if somebody's just like, I got a new phone number just to talk to you. Fine, let's talk it out then. But deleting people, it's so satisfying. It feels so good. And the reason it feels good, the reason deleting people feels so good is because deleting people is the only thing. Deleting people is the only way a functioning member of society, a normal person, can feel what it's like to be a murderer. And that sounds a little bit insane. That sounds a little bit crazy. And we just got a new piece of reinforcement, but she can't actually move because of a bug. Don't know how to fix that. If anybody's ever experienced this bug before and knows how to deal with it, let me know in the comments below. But the deleting people from your phone or whatever, that's the closest you can get as a functioning member of society to murder. And that's the truth. And if you want to test that, if you think I'm full of shit, if you think I'm crazy right now, and you may well think I'm crazy, delete your best friend off Facebook right now. And tell me that won't make you feel, I actually have to kill him. We're going to fire the pistol in his face. Wombo combo. He just melted. He melted. But delete somebody off your friends list that you don't really want to delete. And just realize how amazing. Just it might not even feel amazing, but just feel all the things that go on in your body. A chemical change is going to happen when you delete somebody. It's going to be a lot of emotions. I'm not going to lie to you. And it may even be hard to deal with. But, oh, it's going to be worth it. Because you're going to get that. It's going to be like, I don't want to do this, Jeff. Or whoever your best friend is. It's probably Jeff. That's a common enough name, right? That your best friend's name is Jeff. I don't want to do this, but you forced my hand. And then you hit the button and Jeff is gone. Jeff is gone. Don't delete him from your phone, though, because you probably don't remember his number anyway, even if he's your best friend. Like, nobody remembers phone numbers anymore. Because if you delete his phone number and from Facebook, you'll never see him again, because there'll be no way for you to re-get in contact with him, because you don't know how to spell his last name either. So, like, it's game over. But seriously, we're going to actually start advancing, because we've cleared out a decent amount of them. I don't have to advance, but I'm going to, because I don't know if my snipers will get proper line of sight, so I just want to make sure I've got units at the ready, just in case. Overwatch. But yeah, just right, delete. I don't want to have to do this, Jeff. I don't want to have to get rid of you. But desperate times call for desperate measures. And then you delete him. You deleted Jeff. Jeff gone forever. And you're thinking to yourself, wow, Jeff is freaking gone. And he's never coming back. I don't know. Maybe I'm talking nonsense, but tell me in the comments below, have you ever deleted somebody from your friends list? Have you ever had an argument with a significant other or an ex-girlfriend, ex-boyfriend, and you deleted them? Did it feel good? Because all I'm trying to say, and because this explanation has gotten completely out of control, all I'm trying to say is I have fun deleting people, and the reason I'm bringing this up is because I am very close to deleting somebody from my contacts list right now and blocking them as well, so that's why this is coming up in conversation for me. All right? All right. So we've got enemy reinforcements coming, so we're starting to see the salt levels building, and we're also starting to see the soft enrage timer effect that is coming into play. The reinforcements are going to come, and they're just going to keep coming, and they're going to make this more and more difficult as they continue to pile on. So we got a free reload, and we actually, can we not see anybody? Apparently we can't see anybody from back here with Tracy Donald, so we are going to move up just a little bit. Don't necessarily want to move her up because she is a sniper, but it is going to be worth it in this case because boom, 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 we're going to tap this guy in the chest dead. Ooh, that is a beautiful shot. That may be the screenshot for the thumbnail. So this is actually starting to get a little bit unsavory because we're starting to get into territory where I don't really want to be, in the sense that we're going to actually get flanked now. We're going to get flanked, and those guys are going to wake up and they're going to start taking shots. They're going to probably shoot at Argus when he's... But we've got to start moving up. We've got to start... I need to get line of sight. It's starting to get crazy now. I'm starting to get a little worried. I've been feeling myself, and now I'm starting to get worried. But you know what? This is not going to do 10 damage, and this is not going to crit. Fuck it. Girl. Better get that. All right, so we have visual confirmation on the spike. Ah! I do have line of sight on it, and I can't actually see it with Oliver Jones. It's only going to take him 2 shots to eliminate it, so that is very good. So I can actually pull Lee Mei Ho back. This is like the quickest Avenger defense mission I've ever done. This is only going to take roughly 30 minutes? Oh, this is crazy. All right, so this guy is no longer panicking. Yeah, his panic's been removed. Reinforcements are coming in. I'm surprised this is going so well. I don't think they had an Andromedon on the map, or maybe they did. I can't even remember at this point. I'm tired, people. I'm ready to go to bed right now. But I'm excited. I'm going to go to bed. I'm going to have some good dreams about murdering Advent. That's going to be exciting. Oh, man. Well, it's not going to be about that, though, because that shot wasn't very good, so I'm not really... Neither was that. Oh, come on, guys. I was having a really good moment, and they're sort of taking it away from me. Oh yeah, moment starting to fade. Please shoot it, Argus. No. Okay, it's okay. Okay. So here's what's gonna happen. We're gonna reload with Oliver Jones, and then we're gonna take a shot at the objective and eliminate it. The spike has been cleared. Oliver Jones out of retirement. Boom, baby, boom. Eliminated the objective, and now we can start pulling everybody back. Holy crap.
Shen, what's our status?
Whatever it was, destroying it seems to have lifted the disruption field. Engine control systems are coming back online. We should be clear to take off within 60 seconds.
Okay, so you know what? The main reason this was so simple was because we got that crazy wombo combo on the first pod. That is hands down the only reason this went so simply. Like, we had 4 Chrysalid, 3 Mutant, and a Codex or something. Like, it was crazy. So we got really lucky on this one. I'm not going to deny that for a second. But I'm happy about it. So what's going to happen now is we're going to start pulling people back. But what we're also going to do is we're going to pick up this loot, first of all. You best believe we're going to take everything with us. Look at that. Argus bending down to pick up some loot. Got a data pad, a superior stock. Oh, finally. So the difference between the level 1 stock and the superior stock is the damage that the missed shots will deal. So everybody has equipped a standard stock right now, which means their missed shots deal 1 damage. Well, not everybody, but some of the guys. But the superior stock means they will deal 3 damage even if they miss. So we're going to equip that on some of the guys that are using the stocks right now. So there we go. Picked up some items. And now Argus I want to get him out of the heat right now. Chlori, I'm keeping him safe. His time hasn't come. So we're going to use our overdrive. Not because we're going to run all the way back to the base like a headless chicken, but I want to cover a little bit more distance. And then I want to turn around and take a shot. And that is exactly what we're going to do. Got a decent shot on this guy. What the hell? What the hell? Let's see if we can get this guy. That's what I'm talking about. Who needs lasers, right? Who needs magnetic weapons? We've got standard ballistics on Argus, and he's still whooping that ass. All right, so we do have... It's going to take more than a single turn to get everybody to safety. So the plan is going to be to get people to relative safety and then start taking shots and clear out as many guys as possible. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. So we're moving. I'm kind of just adding insult to injury. Like, these guys just got here, and I kind of just want to kill some fools. Honestly, that's what this is about. I'm taking out my frustrations from my personal life, from my quote-unquote regular life, on these advent troopers. Oh, yeah, they're going to get it. And they're going to get it good. Hello, Tracy. You ready to shoot this guy in the chest? I think you are. Oh, she shot him in the face. Even better. And she got a promotion. You guys heard that. Let's see. Do I have a good shot on him? Yeah, we do. And Rob Cool Blue can sprint straight back to the base at the end of this turn. Get out of here, man. Y'all shouldn't have come. You know? They must not have got the call. The call that Oliver Jones was here. The call that Oliver Jones was back in action. And before I forget, I'm actually going to teleport these other guys back to Cursor so that they don't get left behind. That is a cool feature about the Avenger Defense mission, is that you can actually leave people behind. You can actually end the mission without all of your soldiers getting evac'd. So it's like, go without me. It's like, we're not leaving without you. It's not right. It's like, we're leaving. No. Something like that. You know what I'm talking about from the movies and the things and the, you know. So we're going to end the turn. And I don't know if you can hear the noise outside, but I think it is a voting truck that is canvassing right now, because there is a local election coming up pretty soon for me. I'm not running for any sort of... I said a local election is coming up for me. I'm not running for an office or something. It's just, you know, councilmen and shit. And yeah, more reinforcements are coming. So that would have come immediately after the last pot of reinforcements. So if we didn't clean this out, we would have been in some really deep trouble. Very, very deep trouble. But thankfully, this went really well. Man, I ain't even mad at it. I almost fucked up. I almost messed up and left Argus behind. We're pulling everybody back. I think this is everybody. Yeah, Argus is the last one, so he's coming in hot. And then there he goes. What the hell? Let's do a circle cam just for fun. Let's take a look at this squad view. Look at that. That's pretty. That's pretty. Oh, man. This was flawless. So, ladies and gentlemen, the name of the game is XCOM 2. The name of the channel is iBluairJgR. Wait, where's the button? Yeah, close it up. No. Is that it? Wait, how do I end it? I just have to evac everybody. Hold on. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, so now. Officially now, name of the game is XCOM 2. Name of the channel is iBluairJGR Gaming for Comedy, aka We Did Not Cheat Today. Boom, baby, boom. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.